My friends, once again, we come to the presence of God, and especially we learn from Scripture. We go to a passage that is John chapter 14. In fact, this is a passage that everybody loves, and one of the most comfortable passages in the Bible. And whenever you are in trouble, you just read this passage, John chapter 14. So that's something that gives us comfort, peace, everything. So the very first verse, you know, you go and read the whole passage when you go home, but now we have no time to explain those things, but we say the very first verse, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? So Jesus says again, verse 3, and when I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may also be. See, Jesus says to his disciples, let not your hearts be troubled. It is quite possible that sometimes we lose our heart. We are human beings. But God says, Jesus says, let not your hearts be troubled. Do not lose your heart. And this passage, not every Jack and Jill come and say, let your heart be not be troubled and things like that. When somebody is trying to comfort us, when somebody is saying, don't worry, I am with you, we will look at that person. If this person is with me, or if he is comforting me, I need to see that he is able to do the things that I need. Only then I can be comforted. Suppose when I am very much concerned or very much without strength in my heart, suppose a person from the street, he comes and say, don't be afraid and things like that, I cannot accept it. So when somebody says like that, I look at that person. So it is Jesus who says that, let not your hearts be troubled. And he has all the right to say that. Only he can say this. No other person can comfort you like this. Yes, let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe in also me. And then he says, my comfort that I am giving is not temporary. It is everlasting. Why it is everlasting? Because I'm going, but I'm not going by leaving you alone. And I'm not leaving you forever. I'm leaving, and I'll be with the Father, and I will prepare a home and a board for you. So in my Father's house, there are many rooms. Rooms is not a good translation, in fact. Many mansions, that's a better translation. Some translations are like that. In my Father's house, there are many mansions. If it were not so, would I have been, I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you. So, when I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also. So I'm going to do something. I'm going to prepare a mansion for you, a place for you. So when I prepare, I will come back and I will take you so that you also will be with me forever where I am. That is a comfort that we receive from Jesus. So there is a clause. There are promises without any clause, but there are promises with a clause. What is a clause? Believe in God and believe also in me. Believe means here, it is not just saying that you believe that God is there, you believe that I am here, nothing like that. The belief, in many times in the Bible, it speaks of trusting. Trust in me, maybe you can say like this. Trust in God and also trust in me. Jesus is saying these things because his disciples, it is yet for them to understand that God the Father and Jesus, it's the same. When they trust Jesus, they are trusting God. They are trusting God. True. So, believe in God and also in me. And if you trust in me, then certainly I will take care of everything. Not just when you are in this world, but also when you die, still in eternity, you can trust me. You can trust me for eternity. So when we trust in God, or when we trust in Jesus, we can trust him completely because he will never fail. You see, sometimes we are trusting in people, we are trusting in money, we are trusting in many, many things. But many times they fail, and that's the reason why sometimes, you know, we were wondering, even big celebrities, film actors, and very rich people, many of them commit suicide. Why? They also trust in something, but the thing or the person whom they trust, they couldn't find permanency in that. When we trust in something, it should be permanent. So in Psalms, we read 62, in Psalms 62, there is a very good example is given in verse 3. How long will you set upon a man to shatter him, all of you, like a leaning wall, a tottering fence? See, when you are trusting in a man, it is like a leaning wall. Leaning wall means already it doesn't have any foundation. It is leaning to one side. What will happen if you are trying to lean on a leaning wall, or, you know, put your weight upon a leaning wall? The wall also will fall. You also will fall. The wall will fall and you also will fall. Right? It's the same when you are trusting in money, when you are trusting in people, when you are trusting in positions. Because it is not permanent. Permanent. These are all present realities. Present realities. So, in Bible, especially Solomon says that it is vanity, vanity, everything is vanity. Even in Eastern religion, there is a word called vanity. In Sanskrit, it is maya. Vanity. But there is a big difference between vanity or maya in Hindu philosophy and vanity in biblical understanding. In Hindu philosophy, maya or vanity means illusion. Illusion means there is nothing like that. They say, everything is an illusion. Even if your life, it is an illusion. If you feel pain, it is an illusion. If you think you are living, it is an illusion. So that's what Hindu philosophy says. Vanity. But according to Solomon, vanity is not illusion. Vanity is present reality. It is not permanent reality. It is present reality. Because these are only realities of this world. It is not permanent. So that's why I say that when you are trusting upon a person, it is not eternal reality. It is only present reality. And any time they can fail. It is like putting your weight upon a leaning wall. The wall will fall and you also will fall. But in the same chapter of Psalms, verse 2, we have read verse 3, but verse 2, He only is my rock, my salvation, my fortress, I shall not be greatly moved. So trusting in God, God is a rock, and men are like leaning wall. You see the difference? God is like a rock. If you're leaning on a rock, do you think that the rock will fall down? No. Likewise, if you're leaning on God, if you're trusting God, then you will never fail. If you trust in man, you will fail. If you trust in money, you will fail. If you trust in your education, that will fail. Sometimes people think, I am so intelligent. But let me ask you one thing. If your head hit on a wall, it is all gone. It's only for 1 second to lose all your intelligence. In 1 second. Money is the same. In 1 day you can lose all your money. Health. How many people we have seen, very strong people, they were leaning upon their health. I used to tell the example of Cassius Clay, Muhammad Ali, who was the world champion in boxing. I've seen in the television once when he was lighting the lamp of the Olympics, his hands were shivering, you know, he couldn't hold the lamp. Once he was considered as the strongest person in the whole planet Earth. How can we depend upon, how can we trust upon our health or money or position, anything? No, it's all like leaning walls. But trust in God. Trust in Jesus. That's why Jesus said, trust in God and also trust in me. Then you will never lose your heart. Do not lose your heart. That's what we see there. Chapter 15 of John. We see it's not just leaning. It is when in 14, chapter 14, we see, let not your hearts be troubled, believe in me, believe in God and also believe in me. In 15, chapter 15, verse 4, abide in me and I in you. It's not just leaning. A new word is coming, abiding. That is the Christian word. It's not leaning. We cannot abide in a person, but when you trust Jesus, when you have relation with Jesus, you are not just leaning upon Jesus, but you are abiding in Jesus. And Jesus says, abide in me and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. So it is not just leaning, it is abiding. Abiding is not visiting. As I told in the previous episodes, sometimes, you know, we consider it as visiting. Sometimes, you know, people visit the presence of God. No, it is not visiting that is needed, abiding. We need to abide in Jesus. So my friends, chapter 14 of John, it is a very comforting chapter. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. And also he says, it is not a temporary trust, or I'm not promising something temporary. No, what I'm promising, in my Father's house there are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have been would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you, and when I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, and where I am, you also be. So when Jesus comes back, he will take us, and we will be with him where he is. We'll be living with him. But if you want to live with him in eternity, now we need to see that we are abiding in Jesus. And when you abide in Jesus, that is an assurance that even after death, you will not be separated. If you abide in Jesus, that is a permanent setup. So you will be abiding in Jesus forever and ever. Let's close our eyes. Lord, it is your promise that our heart should not be troubled, because you are in control. We trust in you, O God. We trust in Jesus. And Lord, you have gone to heaven to prepare a mansion for us. So after some time, we will be with you in heaven. But we want to see that here in this world, we are abiding in you and enjoying you, O God. Not just visiting your presence, but we want to see that, Lord, we are living in you, O God. Abiding in you, O God. Lord, our hearts are not troubled, because we know who you are. You are our Savior, you are our Father, you are our Creator, you are the mighty God, and you will promise. Your promise you will fulfill. We believe it, O God. We look for your second coming so that we can be with you where you are. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.